Okay. Hi, everybody, and welcome back to The Wolf Among Us. Basically, I tried to basically record this, but yeah, didn't flipping have enough for now. So, yeah, don't have to put my subtitles back on. No, I don't.
Sorry.
Who are you?
Who are you?
Rachel, who are you? Just so...
I'm Big B.
This is Snow.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Is there,
Is Auntie Greenleaf?
Is Auntie Greenleaf at home? Does she live here?
You mean my mom?
She ever, you know, make the nightstand levitate, turn frogs into cats, that kind of thing?
Is she a witch, dear?
No, I would never call my mommy that. She treats me all right. Is there something you want?
May I look around?
I can really help you.
Rachel, do you mind if I take just a quick peek around?
We'll be very quick, and he won't touch anything.
Let me guess. Big band or classical?
Honky tonk.
No accounting for taste. That your mom?
Uh-huh.
Your mom a hunter?
Oh no, she never... That was found in the woods around Dick's Mountain.
Lots.
No one's been over all night, so...
He's just going to check.
The Butcher.
What's that?
A package having to do with someone called the Butcher. I saw one just like it at the Tweedle's office. God damn it.
I shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
Whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. No, please, just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break it.
I don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay?
Why the little kid?
Why Rick? Why the little girl?
I don't think that's any of your business, Wolf.
Why?
How about because it works? That's why. I'm good enough for you. Certainly kept you two off the scent for a while.
A short while. All right, start explaining.
Where's Crane?
Where's Crane? Speak quickly.
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something.
Unless you want to.
Why are you protecting Crane?
Why, in the name of everything holy, are you protecting this weaselly scumbag? I mean, what on earth could he have done to deserve this kind of loyalty?
Crane could be hollow bones tomorrow, and you wouldn't see me cry a drop. But that doesn't mean I can tell you anything. You have friends, don't you?
Who are you talking?
I'm not protecting Crane. Who are you protecting?
Get this through both of your skulls. I can't tell you. Just you being here is bad enough. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Crane.
We can
protect you, okay? Whatever it is you're afraid of, we can make sure that it won't come to pass.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap. If she's afraid for her life, we can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No! How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the fables who can't afford the glamours from you come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous living this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
And very different means to handle it, too.
And the tree have to go.
As an excuse to wreck people's lives.
Greenleaf Snow's right. The tree has to go.
No! Look, look, I'll tell you. Crane was here. He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He thinks it's the ring of despair. Here's the protection around the girl's speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago. Just please, you can catch him if you leave, okay? Just leave. And don't burn my tree.
Orders.
Anyway, guys, if you guys enjoyed this episode, please like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, I will see you guys on the next episode. Thanks for watching. Bye.